me, now open this door.
What's the use?
What's going on?
Dr. Higgs and Dr. Loken have decided to protest your appointment as father's successor. They've taken control of the bioscience security systems and cut off our food supply.
Oh, great. Like I don't have enough problems.
Well, I'm sorry you've been inconvenienced, but solving personnel issues is part of an administrator's job.
Maybe I can reason with them.
I believe I can help with that. I can unlock the maintenance tunnel that leads to the bioscience observation room. From there, you should be able to communicate with Higgs and Loken. If you can't reason with them, you can use this holotape to access the command functions on the observation room terminal. That should give you some options. Just please, try to talk to them first. Use violence only as a last resort. Unlocked.
There we go. Nice.
Personal record, Dr. Brian Virgil. This will likely be my last recording. My requests to shut down the FEV program have repeatedly been denied. We've learned nothing useful in the last 10 years. Why does Father insist on continuing it? If he won't see reason, then I have to take matters into my own hands. What we're doing, it's not right. It needs to stop. If anyone should find this after I'm gone. Know that I never wanted to hurt anyone. Anyone! Do you understand me? I'm gonna make sure the whole program is shut down. If not for good, then at least for years to come. After that, I know what I'm about to do will be seen as a betrayal. Treason, he'll probably call it. So, I'm leaving. I have a plan, and if it works, I'll be somewhere safe. Somewhere not even the coursers can find me. Everything that we've done, the lives we've taken. If there is a God, may he have mercy on us all.
The guards, Impressive. If you've come to change our minds, then you're wasting your time.
You're upset. I get it. You've made your point. Now open the door.
I'm not taking orders from you. You haven't earned my respect, and you never will.
Don't force me to take drastic measures, Doctor.
Oh, so you mean to martyr us then? I assure you, Dr. Loken and I are prepared to make any sacrifice in order to uphold the ideals of the Institute.
You're a stubborn fool, and you're not gonna like how this ends.
Nor will you. If you leave us here, everyone else will starve because you were too stubborn to refuse Father's appointment. Remove us by force, and everyone will fear and despise you. I'm afraid you lose either way.
Heir apparent. She made it past your impenetrable defenses.
Compose yourself, man. hostile sensor detected.
Excuse me, Doctor.
That was unfortunate. We don't like violence here, and I fear your actions will have consequences.
Stop whining, and be grateful I got your food supply back.
Yes, of course. Sorry if I seemed ungrateful. I'll see that the mess in hydroponics is cleaned up. I suppose I should also make the funeral arrangements. Well, there's much to do, so I'll get about it. In the meantime, I'm sure everyone will be relieved that this is over.
Thank you. got me down. Uranium fever, it's spreading all around. With a Geiger counter in my hand,
I'm going out to stake me some government land.
Uranium fever has done and got me down. Well, I took the Geiger and I started to climb right up to the top where I thought I'd find a hunk of rock that'd make it click just like I'd read about Vernon Pitt. On the second day, I made the top, and I'm telling you, Steve, I was ready to stop. The only clicking that I heard that day was the bones in my back that had gone astray.
Uranium fever has done and got me down. Uranium fever, it's spreading all around.
With a Geiger counter in my hand,
I'm going out to stake me some government land.
Uranium fever has done and got me down. Well, you pack up your things, you head out again into some unknown spot where nobody's been. You reach the spot where your fortune lies. You find it's been staked by 17 other guys. Well, I ain't kidding, I ain't gonna quit. That bug's done caught me and I've been bit. So with a Geiger counter and a pick in my hand, I'll keep right on staking that government land.
Uranium fever has done and got me down. Uranium fever is spreading all around.
With a Geiger counter in my hand,
I'm going out to stake me some government land.
Uranium fever has done and got me down.
That was Uranium Fever by Elton Britt. You're tuned to the Commonwealth's only respite from the tedium and desperation of post-apocalyptic life. Diamond City Radio. Here's a classic from Billie Holiday. It's Easy Living.
Starting to worry we might not make it out of this mess.
It wouldn't have been such a mess if you'd handled it differently.
I never claimed to be suited for field work, and I explicitly stated that when given this assignment. Mercenaries. You believe that? There was no intelligence to suggest that he was that paranoid. I know he's potentially important to Phase 3 and all, but I'm not sure it's worth putting ourselves in harm's way.
As far as I can tell, you were only in harm's way because you screwed this up.
Look, I had the same intelligence reports as everyone else. No one saw this coming. I know they've been keeping an eye on him for years. Not sure how they originally found him, but probably don't want to know. But once they realized how smart he was and what an asset he could be for Phase 3, they watched pretty closely. I think they even fed him scientific material from time to time to see how good he was, you know, testing him, to see if he was Institute material. Let's just get Wallace and get out of here.
What do you mean, get Wallace? You don't have him already?
I know. There's a slight problem with that. He doesn't want to go with us. I was thinking, maybe you could try and talk to him.
I guess I'll have to, since you're useless.
I think that's a little unfair.
And I'm so in love. There's nothing in life but you.
Mr. Wallace, I'm here to talk to you.
You're another one of them, aren't you? Are you a robot?
Please try and relax. I know this is an unusual situation.
No! You're here to kidnap me! That's what you people do, isn't it? If you even are people. I've heard all the stories. I know exactly what happens to people when the Institute shows up. Well, it's not happening to me.
Hey, hey, just calm down, okay? I just want to talk to you.
Fine, fine. What do you want from me?
The Institute needs your help, Mr. Wallace. It's as simple as that.
My help? With what?
The Institute has an engineering problem that your scientific expertise could help solve. In exchange for helping us out, you'd be granted access to the most advanced research facility imaginable. Whatever research you wanted to perform, anything, it's possible there. I promise. You'd be safe and secure in a way that's completely impossible anywhere else.
Think about your future, Wallace. This is a way to secure it.
I suppose that's one way to look at it. Okay, fine. I'll go.
I'm looking forward to working for you, future director. Okay. I think we've got this under control now. Thanks. I mean, thanks for the assist.
Screw you. There are plenty of things I'd rather have done than come fix your mess.
Wow. Okay. Message received. I'll see you back in the Institute.
Doc?
You must be pretty excited being named the next director.
From what I hear, that rogue synth that led Italia was truly a menace. Glad it's back where it belongs. I wonder if it's a reaction to
it. It must make you proud to see all that Father has done, all that he has built.
Hello.
I wish I had more time to spend with Quinn, but I hope you understand. Be in two places at once.
I used to work exclusively on the synth projects, but lately I prefer less animated pursuits.
I know it'll be a difficult adjustment for you, but try to remember that synths aren't people.
There you are. I cannot express how pleased I am. Our new guest is familiarizing himself with his surroundings. Yet he's already pointed out several inefficiencies in our methods. With his help, Phase 3 will be ready in no time. And it's all thanks to you.
Well, maybe it's because I'm the only one who seems to actually be doing anything.
Come now. Countless hours have been spent building and readying the reactor. True, you have endured some of the more dangerous missions. Such is the price of leadership. There is one more part for you to play, and I think you might enjoy it. It is time to announce our presence to the Commonwealth, to request that they do not interfere with our plans. You should be the one to do it.
Right, because no one up there suspects the Institute exists.
This is not a joke. There's been too much posturing by too many groups. The world needs to know that we are in power and the Commonwealth is ours. As the incoming director, it is your responsibility to lead, to establish that place for the Institute's future. Please take this seriously. We've prepared some remarks for you to record. Once you're finished, we'll broadcast them to the entire Commonwealth. Use the microphone here and follow the script. It's quite simple. I'm sure you'll do fine, Mother.
Good to see you.
Unit X-688 speaks highly of your combat skills.
Sounds like those raiders have been taking quite a handful.
We don't usually welcome outsiders. I hope you can appreciate your good fortune. For years now, you have suspected that the Institute still exists, that we are among you. It's true. But it's not the whole truth. We are here, and we are... your new masters. Our superior technology represents the future of the Commonwealth. Today, we activate our nuclear reactor, ensuring that we will persevere long after the world above ground ceases to exist, ensuring that mankind has a future. We have no desire to interfere in the unimportant details of your pathetic existences. We simply insist that you do not interfere with Institute operations. To do so would result in your complete annihilation. Rest easy. Know that the future is out of your control, and that mankind will thrive under our guidance.
Well, that was interesting. Perhaps not what we originally intended, but it will certainly get your point across. Now it's time to make sure that everyone hears it. How would you feel about making a little trip to Diamond City?
I'll go if it's necessary.
It absolutely is. The radio station in Diamond City is listened to by many in the Commonwealth. If we'd like the people to hear what we have to say, it's the best way to reach them. Before we preempt their broadcasts, we need to ensure it reaches the maximum range possible. I've been assured that the necessary parts are on site. You'll just need to install them to boost the broadcasting power. Report back when you're done. We should be ready by then.
posted outside the wall.
Thank God they saw.
Things with Scarlet didn't really, work out. But that's fine.
Okay. Let's try this. Maybe this goes... here.
Stand of yours.
Every drop of water that comes out of that filter is 100% pure. Why is a legitimate businessman like myself always got to be hassled by city regulation, huh?
It's a health hazard, Shane.
It's a profit hazard, is what I say. I manage the water, and I'll do it without your interference. Thank you very much.
Nice piece you got there. Just
hi there.
Hey there, purified water. You won't find this out on the Commonwealth.
Anything I can do to help out?
Ah, the industrious type. Wanna help me clean out the water supply? You won't believe the junk people throw in there. Overloads the filters.
Depends. What's this worth to you?
Job's 100 caps, but I like you. 125.
Come on. My time's worth more than that.
150, then.
We're both business people, Shing. Don't insult me.
All right, 200. High as all go.
What kind of stuff is down there?
You're looking for big things. Anything around the size of a book, usually.
I'm on it.
Just don't drown. I'll never clean your carcass out of there.
Hey, Shang.
Look how clean the water is now. Good job. Here's your pay. Now, how about you pick up some bottles for the road?
Shang, why was there a skull in the water?
So maybe you weren't the first person I asked. Maybe the last guy found an unstable hand grenade. Hey, once the filters do their job, it's all water under the bridge. Am I right? Anyway, need some water?
Shop in safety. No synths allowed at the surplus.
No skull in the lake. It was Stan, a swatter.
Word of advice.
Never call your mother a synth unless she requires one.
Prescriptions, Bill. High-quality cam.
Super Salon can give you the...
We sell cuts of meat. That's it. I've got a few minutes to browse.
As for...
Let's see what you got.
Self.
Talk to me. Might attract someone's attention.
The synths are treating you well, I hope.
Enjoy your trip to the big city. It's done then. The transmitter has been modified.
If we're gonna turn this thing on, let's get to it.
Yes, I do believe it's time. I'll let you do the honors.
This, my friends, is the moment we've all worked towards. After all your effort, the time has finally come to start our reactor. No longer will we be forced to compromise to survive. No more will we need worry about outpacing our resources. My mother and I couldn't be more proud of what you have helped us accomplish. And we look forward to achieving even greater things in the future. The Institute is now truly mankind's best hope. Thank you. All of you.
Son?
Our advances will, in time, change the world. After all those years of hard work, here we are. We've arrived. Look what you've made possible.
The job's done. That's what matters.
Don't lose sight of the fact that you're to be thanked for this. There's more work to be done before the Institute's future is guaranteed. The Directorate has convened a meeting about how to proceed. I'm not going to attend. You should be there as Director.
One day, I'll design a more efficient reactor to replace that.
The Institute is my life. I hope it'll be yours too.
I have to admit, I've got a third generation sensor.
Makes me thankful for being down here.
Got a minute to patch me up, Dr. Volkert?
Let's have a look. Yep. Rough shape. Here, this should take care of it. All right, that should do it. There's a stock of medical supplies over in requisition.
Hey, Doc.
I fix one relay and two more start to fail.
This place really is remarkable.
Hey there.
To think I'd be above ground, suffering.
I wouldn't be here.
I wish you could have known Father as we have.
I have every
confidence.
May I be
the first to welcome you,
ma'am.
You'll
make a fine director.
We're looking forward to working with you.
Let's just get down to business. Yes, of course.
Right now, we're all here because it's finally time to stand up for ourselves.
Let's not be dramatic, Justin.
There's nothing dramatic about it. We're in a position to push back, to assert ourselves here. That's what we've talked about all along.
To bring you up to speed, obviously there are groups in the Commonwealth that stand in opposition to the Institute's goals. With the reactor now online, we have the ability to not only expand synth production, but to project power to a much greater degree.
So you're saying we can now wage war on the Commonwealth?
I don't think anyone really intended that as a course of action. The Directorate has agreed that steps must be taken to ensure our safety in the long run.
Let's not beat around the bush.
the Directorate has agreed that the Brotherhood of Steel needs to be eliminated.
As the incoming director, we felt it important to inform you of the decision and get your thoughts on it. So, where do you stand?
I agree. We hit them hard before they have time to react to our new position.
Good. That's just what I wanted to hear.
As director, it's up to you and how we focus our efforts in achieving this goal. We'd like your input on what direction we should take. Do we increase synth production or focus on weapons development?
I've seen enough to know that weapons are the key to winning wars. Let's focus on weapons development.
As you wish. The advanced systems folks will get to work immediately. That's all we have for the moment. I believe Father wished to speak with you once our meeting concluded.
To be frank, I don't agree with this decision, but I'll accept it.
Apologies. I have an urgent message from Z-114.
Your quarters have flooded, ma'am. There is danger of extensive damage to your personal effects.
I'll go right now.
Time is of the essence. To avoid any undue tragedy, please see Z-114. At once.
We're making real progress, thanks to you.
It's my responsibility to make sure this place runs smoothly.
Unit X688 speaks highly of your combat skills.
Unit B592 is undergoing a reclamation process as we speak. Before long, he'll be back in your quarters.
What took R5 so long to reach you? You must act now. The Brotherhood of Steel has discovered the location of the railroad.
If those bastards know where we are...
I know. I was hoping for more time to organize a rebellion, but... it's clear we cannot delay. Once you secure the railroad against the Brotherhood, tell your people we are ready to fight. Go. Now!
Thank you.
every synth that makes it out, there's a roundup.
We have a backlog of synths in the pipe. Let's get them out of the Commonwealth, safely.
C1's rebellion is ready, but we have a crisis. The Brotherhood's on their way here.
What? What are you talking about?
The Institute. Caught wind of a surprise attack.
Jesus. Quick, take this. Tom made it for you. Sounds like we're going to need it. Everyone else, mobilize. We got Brotherhood incoming.
Assume defensive position.
Tomorrow.
Glory was guarding the entrance, but she may already be overwhelmed by the Brotherhood.
I'll clear the catacombs.
Do it!
I'm too damn pissed to be scared right now!
Training drills.
None of them got past me. Damn, that stings. Listen, the railroad's always sitting on its hands. You're the best thing that's ever happened. Promise me you'll free them. All of them.
I promise.
If anyone isn't there supposed to be a light?
That.
Desdemona.
You've killed the last of them, and you're still standing. I wish the same could be said for Glory. No time for that, though. The Brotherhood underestimated us badly. Their next attack will be far, far worse. So we do the unexpected. We eliminate the Brotherhood as a threat now, and the key to that is destroying their flying fortress, the Pridwin. Fortunately, we've got a contingency plan for that. Tom, we're activating Operation Red Glare.
What? But Red Glare requires a Brotherhood vertebrae.
Then Fixer will get you one.
Sure, I'll just swing by the local super-duper mart and pick one up. Need some milk, too?
This isn't the time. The Brotherhood's occupied the Cambridge police station. Spotters report they almost always have a vertebrate parked on its roof. Take it. And Tom, you're going with her.
Me? In the field?
No one else can fly the damn thing. This one's for Glory. Move out.
Hey there.
I leave HQ for a second, and that's when the Brotherhood hits us.
Damn it!
You must have beat them, though. Their vertebrates just bugged out. How bad was it down there?
We've got a lot of dead railroad agents.
Shit. So now the Brotherhood's got our number. I'll meet you at the police station. We're not out of the frying pan yet.
Hey there.
Hey, sister. You looking to earn some caps?
Depends on the job.
Hear me out. I've got a lead on a crash site. Big old jet. That much scrap could be worth a lot to the right buyer. Trouble is, some raiders are holed up in it. Help me run them off, and I'll give you a cut of the profit. How about 50 caps? Sound fair?
Dude, come on. Make it worth my time.
100.
You can do better than that.
150.
How many raiders?
Not sure. I stopped counting when they started shooting. Maybe 8 or 10? Now are you in or not?
I'm in.
All right. There's a little ridge just south of the crash site. Meet me there, and we'll take them on together.
About the mission, Tom?
The police station is crawling with Brotherhood guys. At least one in power armor. But as promised, they got a vertebrate on the roof. You really up for this?
It's payback time.
Prepping that vertebrate for takeoff is gonna take me a few minutes. So first, we gotta clear the police station of hostiles. For glory.
Hey.
We got ourselves some wheels! Or wings, or whatever this is. Here's the deal. After flight prep, we take the vertebrate up to the Pridwin and dock. From the inside, the blimp's vulnerable. To keep that baby afloat, it's got massive gas bags full of hydrogen.
Tell me about my role in this.
Your job is tricky. You gotta find a way to place these explosives on the gas bags. Then get the hell back to our vertebrate. Make it to a comfortable distance, then it's bye-bye Pridwin. Flight prep is going to take time. And the Brotherhood's not just going to give it to us. So if Paladins show up, keep them off me and the bird.
Want me back on deck, huh? I gotta admit, things have been pretty quiet without you.
Not right now.
Well, if you change your mind.
So, the manual said... Right. Okay. Where's the master switch?
Man, we've got a vertebrate coming.
Oil pressure, check. Oh, shit, I'm going as fast as I can in here. But I don't know what's this panel even do? Throttle, full open.
Deacon.
First things first, I picked up some Brotherhood goodies for you. Merry Christmas. More importantly, though, Tinker's ready for us on the bird. Let's go.
Thank you.
like falling off a log.
Dear God, we're dead.
Launch Bay 3. Deck officer is requesting an update on the police station.
Hostiles eliminated.
Scimitar status. Confirm.
Scimitar took some fire. Should be up and running in a few hours.
We have a visual on you, Claymore. Your docking port's not open.
Got some technical difficulties with the port thingy. Working on it. Huh?
Yeah, but what is it? There?
Claymore, you're clear for approach.
Take too long in there. If anyone comes over here, I don't know if I can fool them. Good luck.
The Prinquin is a magnificent ship.
Attention. This is a notice to all personnel. Please think of your brothers and sisters down below.
Not a good time to keep me waiting.
Thoroughly secure all gear while on the flight deck. Thank you.